Hello everyone and welcome back to FG Tech Tips. We are going to look at an hard drive docking station today, as I had to find a replacement for my previous one. I've been using this docking station, USB 3.0 docking station, for around 5 years now, but it recently just died. So I've been looking around online for a decent replacement, and my choice was focused on this Sabrent model. This is the USB 3.1 version. My motherboard supports up to 3.2 Gen 2, but I was not able to find any docking station supporting that. If you are following my channel, you already know that this is not the first Sabrent product I've been reviewing. If you're interested, you can check my 1TB Sabrent Rocket M.2 review. Great choice for the price. So right here, and you might also know that Sabrent is becoming a very popular US brand in PC gaming hardware, as they were also among the first to release a PCI Express 4 M.2 drive. As we know from the official specs, USB 3.0 is capable of a maximum transfer rate of 5 gigabits per second, while USB 3.1, 3.1 Gen 2 doubles that speed, reaching 10 gigabits per second. And USB 3.2 Gen 2 doubles once again that theoretical speeds, so the maximum transfer rate goes up to 20 gigabits per second. The model number of this product right here is a DSUTC1. I got it for $35 on Amazon, and it's basically a serial data docking station that supports direct insertion of desktop 2.5 inch or 3.5 inch serial data hard drives. And we will see that we can connect it to our PC via the ordinary USB port or also a USB-C port, which is quite convenient for many of us. Looking at the specs anyway, as we said, it's fully compatible with USB 3.1 with transfer rates up to 10 gigabits per second, but it's obviously also reverse compatible with USB 2.0 and 3.0. But in that case, obviously the transfer rate will drop down to 408 megabits per second or 5 gigabits per second. The installation is toolless and there is no need of any software or driver since it's plug and play. The purchase of this docking station is also mandatory if yours is quite old, as it most likely won't support high capacity drives. This one is certified to be compatible with hard drives up to 10TB, and probably it will work with sizes even higher than that. I'll be using this drive with an 8TB unit from Seagate. If you wish to know more about that, you can check the review right here. So you might be wondering, why am I using an hard drive via a docking station and why I didn't install it in my PC together with the other drives I have? Well, it's mainly for two reasons. First of all, I'll be using this unit for backup only, and I simply don't need to keep it on the whole time. I will just turn it on when needed. And second, by turning the hard drive on demand, I'm quite confident I will extend this life over time. Also, I don't need extreme performances, as the drive is anyway 5400 RPM, and I usually do small chunks of backups. With that being said, let's move on to a quick unboxing and let's test the performances of this docking station, comparing it to the serial data performances, obviously using the same hard drive on both cases. Let's see now what comes in the box. A basic user manual. A USB-C cable, as we said, and here our docking station, and this is a cable from standard USB to USB-C. Obviously power supply, we can see we have two different power sockets here, so nothing special in the back of the docking station, just have a power on button, the power supply input, and USB 3.1. Inside we can see, as all these docking stations, we have the serial data connectors on the front and operating LED. Now if your motherboard has a USB-C connector, like in my case, we'll be using this one, this cable. Otherwise you will have to use this other cable. So you plug the usual USB in the back of your motherboard, and this other end, the USB-C end, will go directly into this unit here. Now let's install it and test it. We can see that the docking station is quite compact and with a minimal design. Very compact when compared to my previous one. We can now see the performances of the 8TB drive in serial ATA mode, so installed in the computer. And here the difference is using USB 3.1, so with the same drive installed in the Sabrent docking station. As we can see, there are quite some differences in write speeds and in access time. Obviously, all the values indicating megabytes per second indicate an higher score, which is better, while the lower the score, the better it is for the milliseconds related tests. So as we saw from my tests, there was not really so much difference in using the drive externally. I was also surprised that in some scenarios we also gained performances, especially in write speeds and access times. There are also other models from Sabrent, obviously, that will offer additional things like dual drive support, four drive support, or also a docking station with a USB hub integrated in it. But not all of them are supporting USB 3.1 or Type-C, so pay attention when you look at them if USB 3.1 is important for you. That's all for today, folks. Thanks for watching, and remember that if you like this video, you can leave a like and subscribe to the channel. That would be much appreciated. Let me also know in the comments below if you have any questions for me, and I will see you in the next one.